Now, obviously, I don't have to overstate, I don't have to hype up, or I don't have to do anything about this track in order for you to understand the significance. It caught us completely off guard. We knew about the potential rumors, and we seen the posts, and we seen like the little teasers on Instagram from NF and Hobson, and we knew about that one. But nobody, absolutely nobody, knew about this feature right here with Tech 9. And because Tech 9 is on the track, it is by far probably the most anticipated song on the album. You don't even really gotta be a fan of Tech 9 to be hyped about this. You just gotta be like, a little curious. How is this gonna sound? Here are two artists that I never saw linking up. What the hell? What's going on? You know? It's a monumental day in the world of hip-hop and rap collabos, because it's a rap collaboration that nobody saw coming. You wanna know what else nobody saw coming? The fact that this video here has our very first brand sponsor, son. And you might be thinking, which smaller brand or which smaller artist is out there that's willing to sponsor a video from a reactor? Nah. Today's reaction, today's video was sponsored by none other than Honey. And I'm sure if you watch TV a lot, you see the Honey spots. If you watch YouTube a lot, you see the Mr. Beast spots for Honey, but you still don't even know what it is. So let me give you some game for free 99. If you're anything like me, especially during this weird 2020, 2021 that we've had, you do a lot of your shopping online. And that's where today's sponsor Honey steps in and makes your life easier. Honey is literally a free browser extension that you add to your favorite browser, and then it goes out there and scours the internet for you. You don't have to do anything. And if there is a coupon or if there is savings out there to be found, Honey automatically applies it to your shopping cart. Like, what? So let me go ahead and spit game to you real quick and show you exactly how this works. Step number one, all you gotta do is just get Honey on your computer for free. Two clicks. Quite literally, whenever you're checking out on one of 30,000 Honey supported websites, it'll automatically pop up for you, and all you have to do is click apply coupons. Honey goes out there, tests the codes that it can find, and if it finds a code that works, the prices automatically drop. That order that you just saw right there was actually me using Honey. I went on to purchase that and I saved $23.70, and I literally did nothing. You do not want to be missing out on potential savings because you did not do the literally two click process to download Honey. If you have a computer, Honey should be on your browser. End of story. Also, quick side note, the integrity of my word matters on this channel. So I would not be sending you somewhere or endorsing a product where I don't think that you're gonna get immediate benefit, because I have seen myself the immediate benefit. So get Honey for free, like literally right now. Go do it right now. There's no reason to not, by going to joinhoney.com/Ernest. That tells them that I sent you from my video, and that helps promote me, and that helps you potentially save money. Literally a win-win situation. That's joinhoney.com/Ernest, E-R-N-E-S-T, just like the channel. Thank you, Honey, for sponsoring today's video. And now, hold up, my headphones were ready. And now, let's get to this NF Tech 9. Let's get it. My bad, forgot to put my hat on. The string sounds so eerie. It sounds like, what's happening? Like I gotta watch my back. Sometimes I feel like somebody's watching me.
Focus on it every single day. I want to figure out a way to get ahead of what I think I know is coming. Top of you, you got a problem. If you're always trying to make it seem as if you've never been afraid, then why you running? I can never look at what I do the way that other people can and walk away. I can't be separated from it. Sticking on my neck is how I made it where I'm at. You want to cut it up, I can't, and they can never take it from me.
Outlandish.
Just got to get it while I can with my damn it.
Hold up. Obviously, we had a rhyme scheme switch up right there, and a cadence and a delivery pattern switch up. And then obviously the beat done dropped in. So far, just from that little moment that I heard, and then the beginning portion, it sounds like The Search, but it sounds different than The Search. Like the production sounded very heavy and sorrowful, and it's a hard listen if you're not in that mood. But this right here is like, all right, we felt those emotions from The Search, but now we about to get in our bag type vibe. You know what I'm saying? We're coming through with that confidence. I know what you said about me. I know what I said on the last record, but we pushing forward now, you know? And I say that because the very opening line, he's like, I'm always trying to find a way to get in front of what I think is coming. Like he's in his head. He's always trying to be in front of the eight ball. You know what I'm saying? And then just talking to his critics and everybody else who just doubts him. Like if you really didn't have a problem, then where you running from? Why you running? You know? It's fire. But that beat drop and that rhyme scheme switch up.
Sticking on my neck is how I made it where I'm at. You wanna cut it up, I can't, and they can never take it from me. Outlandish, take chances, gotta get it while I can with my damage, my sanity. Ooh. Could leave it if it vanished. Don't matter to me, I'd still manage.
Bro, the rhyme scheme is fire. Fire. I didn't even listen to what he was saying right there, because in my mind, what I was thinking is like the hard A sound, damage, handed, outlandish, managed, like that hard A sound. One of my favorite rhymes. But the switch it from the and then it goes into this that managed, like that's dog clean.
Outlandish, take chances, gotta get it while I can with my damage, my sanity could leave it if it vanished. Don't matter to me, I'd still manage. Yeah, guess you could say
my sanity could vanish. It don't matter to me, I'd still manage. Gotta get it while I can with my damage, bro. Literally getting it while he can from the damage that he's like the damage that's has been put on his soul from life. He is literally making the most out of it. Gotta get it while I can with my damage. My sanity, let's clean, bro.
Don't matter to me, I'd still manage. Yeah, guess you could say I'm at an advantage. My vantage point can be quite lavish. Got so many cadences, the way to pick one, which bag is my hand in? Depends what mood I'm in. Oh.
Bro, that's like four cadence switch-ups right there. And he's talking about it, and I didn't know, but he said, it depends on which bag my hand's in, bro. I'm in my bag, but which bag? I got 30 of them. The beat just drops again, like two drops on the instrumental and three or four cadence switch-ups within the first 45 seconds of the track. It's clean. So crazy. I hope the rest of the mixtape is like this, because this is exactly what I wanted. I wanted him to switch it up. I wanted him a little more confidence.
On which bag is my hand in? Depends what mood I'm in. Oh no, I'm in a mood again. Lord knows I'm a hooligan. Losing it. Who can get gruesome with you if it comes down to it? You can bet.
Yo, this man said, Lord knows I'm a hooligan. Who can get gruesome with? And then the beat just like follows his cadence. Just boom, boom, boom. Yo, clean. The production decision to do that, to drop out everything except for the 808 and have it hit at the very end of the cadence. But he said, what bag do I want to go into? It depends on what mood I'm in. Oh no, I'm in a mood again. Like just such very sarcastic way, like talking to the critics or talking to the people who are just like, oh, all he produces is sad, sorrowful, depressing music. Like, oh my God, I'm in a mood again. Here we go. But this production right here, bro.
Bag is my hand in, depends what mood I'm in. Oh no, I'm in a mood again. Lord knows I'm a hooligan. Losing it, who can get gruesome with you? If it comes down to it, you can bet. I shoot the wreck, defuse the threat, and then wonder why the music has a huge effect. Could it be because I've been the go-to when it comes to death? Cause I'm the one that maybe calling when the people are fed up.
And they wonder why the music had a huge effect. I'm the one that shoots direct. Like I don't beat around the bush. I'm telling it like it is. I'm being 100% real.
Could it be because I've been the go-to when it comes to death? Cause I'm the one that they be calling when the people get fed up. I want the music with the visuals. I got them in dead effect.
This is like five cadence switch-ups. Cause this spit right here, even though it's quick, it's not the same cadence as the cadence that the song opened with.
I want the music with the visuals. I got them in debt. For any part of me to want to make it hard to get set up, but take away the happiness, it can be kind of pathetic. But when I look at everything, it's trying to give me a headache.
Hold on. The spit is crazy, but the instrumental, everything drops out, and then we just get the choir like one note, and then he spits longer, and then the lower note, bro. All right, I got to listen because he's obviously spitting quicker than most ears can hear. Bar.
Take away the happiness, it can be kind of pathetic. But when I look at everything, it's trying to give me a headache. You gotta be honest, I've really been the cause of it. Get it? Cause I can see inside of me, you never see. You can tell when I'm at the brink of point. I finally had to sit with the devil. I went into hell and I asked him with the...
So, yeah, I'm at the brink of, like, I finally had to sit down with the devil, bro. I had to sit his ass down and like, look, we gotta talk. I'm sorry, but we gotta let you go. Severance package, you get the whole works, but it's just not working out. But he said, I'm the one that they be calling when people get fed up and they want the music with the visuals. I got a vendetta. That's fire because, like, the whole storyline, everything that NF is, you know? It's not just the music. It's the music and the symbolism in every video that ties into the one before and the entire cinematic world that he's built just from his music videos alone. Crazy.
At the breaking point, I finally had to sit with the devil. I went into hell and I asked him what the problem is yelling. He tried to get me to live with him, even call me a sinner and told me everything about me doesn't feel like a winner. So I continue when he's telling me I might as well give up. I took a moment, thought about it, feeling caught in the middle. But got offended when he told me I would live in the canon when I could never leave it. Even if I made it to heaven, he found a way to get me back and send a demon to get me. I'm like, whoa, hold up.
Bro, that whole story right there of just like with the devil, just talking to the devil. The devil's always in my ear telling me I'm not good enough. Even when I have the success, the devil's still trying to drag me down. Even when I make it up to the heavens above, the devil's going to send a demon to come and get me and try to drag me. Like, I'm never getting rid of this dude. It's just such good writing.
Send a demon to get me. I'm like, whoa, hold up. So skin and bones, me my ego. How's he look? He don't eat much, let him starve. I don't feed him, I just beat him. I just leave him in his room, in a fetal. Let him cry, let him yell, let him scream. I don't need him. Lift off, no
Yo, this is what I've been needing. from NF right here. And he's talking, it's like he's talking in like to like a third party. Like, yeah, that's the devil. Leave him in the room. Yeah, he's skin and bones. I don't feed him. I don't give in to him. Like, let him die. Let him sit there in the fetal position because he's sad that he's not getting to me in the way that he thinks he is. So dope. And then the beat switch up again, like in the fetal, let him cry, let him boom, boom, it's fire.
I'm in the fetal, let him cry, let him yell, let him scream, I don't need him.
Lift off and I'm ticked off, my pitfalls I latch onto like a pit dog, I sit calm with.
Eight switch ups. I think it's eight. I'm trying to count, but it's so many.
Lift off and I'm ticked off, my pitfalls I latch onto like a pit dog, I sit calm with a sick thought of a sitcom of the life I live's more like a side.
I sit calm with a sick, like sit calm and think about the sitcom, what a life I live, like it's all a joke. It's fire. And then the beat like stops from being aggressive. We had aggression at the moment that we needed it. But now that he's actually like letting us in, talking about like, all right, this is really what's going on inside. The beat chills out. So dope. And just the feeling, like anybody who battles anything mental before in their life, like, you know this feeling. You know when something's not going right, you latch onto the problems and dig yourself further into that hole. That's what it feels like right now with me. Like I latch on to all the negatives in my life versus the positives. And I just, it's like when you're sad and you listen to sad music to get even sadder. That's what he's talking about, but on a more serious level, I guess you could say.
But a life I live's more like a sci-fi flick. I hide in, wanna watch, dive right in. My silence doesn't mean I'm dying, just means I'm careful with the time I spend. So
yo, my silence doesn't mean I'm dying. It just means I'm careful with the time I spend. I'm not wasting a single second on anything anymore. Just because I'm silent doesn't mean that I'm dying. You know? It's dope.
I did. My silence doesn't mean I'm dying. Just means I'm careful with the time I spend. So look what I done. Hey, helping them people I love. My life is not what it was. No, I do whatever I must. Count on one hand, I trust. Count on one hand, I trust. Yeah, count on one hand, I trust. Count on one hand, I trust.
All right, hold on. Now we get into the Tech Nina now. Again, this is probably the one that most people were wanting to listen to just because we already got the one with Hop. I feel like Hop's fan base and NF's fan base is one. So when they started teasing it, everybody was like, oh, damn, this is happening. When's it going to drop? But no one saw Tech Nine.
Kind of one hand, I trust.
Nina, next king up. Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer. That lingua vexing, yeah. Leaving a regular rapper resting, bruh. This is what I...
Bro, the Tech Nine's whole flow style, you either like it or you don't. Everybody respects Tech Nine, but like, I feel like some people just don't like the fast spit machine gun style flow that he basically, not pioneered, but he was one of the ones that did pioneer it. And that's why when people get onto his, like when they bring him on his features, they're like, we're going to cater to your style so that way you can shine, you know? It's dope. It's like mad respect for Tech. But it's just Tech's cadences that are so crazy. Nina, next king up, where everybody went ahead of what, like, then he goes into the fast and then goes out slow again.
Next king up, everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer. That lingua vexing, yeah, leaving a regular rapper resting, bruh. This is what I give it, such an incredible wicked rush, a vivid gush, a poetical livid stuff to rid its gruff. Said I better go rip it rough and I lit it up. The prestige, I got the...
Bro, his whole scheme right here is crazy. Crazy. This is why I give it such a wicked rush. Like, yo, it's dope. And then it's not just like the rhyme scheme, it's the cadence, but it's not just the one cadence. He's got like two different cadences into the same section. So it's like the offbeat flow and then and then back to the offbeat flow and then like, it's so difficult to do as a poet, as a writer.
Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer, that lingua vexing, yeah, leaving a regular rapper resting, bruh. This is what I give it, such an incredible wicked rush, a vivid gush, a poetical livid stuff to rid its gruff. Said I better go rip it rough and I lit it up. The prestige, I got that from people loving the tech.
Ready to go rip it rough, when, yo, like rib it? Like, does he mean like rib it? Like if you're feeling froggy, let's jump.
Poetical livid stuff to rid its gruff. Said I better go rip it rough and I lit it up. The prestige, I got that from people loving the tech speed. Woo. Lyrically elect me, gently, the beat that got you bobbing into your neck bleed. Woo. That is telling me let's feed on the beat of the boat.
Did he say Lorena? Hold on, I gotta rewind. Tech, I can't just catch because of his like staccato style delivery and his rhyme schemes are crazy. Like my brain doesn't know whether to focus on the delivery or to focus on the scheme. So it's like scrambled.
Prestige, I got that from people loving the tech speed. Woo. Lyrically elect me, gently, the beat that got you bobbing into your neck bleed. Woo. That is telling me let's feed on the beat of the boat.
The beat has got your head bobbing till your neck bleed, and then it's telling me let's feed, like let's eat these rappers, bro. Tech is crazy. He is definitely one of the like most iconic rappers in the game ever.
Let's feed on the beat of the boat. Gets to hit the book. focus. Deliver the doses and give a credit to the dopest. Spit it to flow, sick another critic corrosive. A swig of the rogue is to give you liver cirrhosis.
Bro, you swig it, give you liver cirrhosis, swig, give you liver cirrhosis like an alcoholic, bro. But do you just hear the scheme when it comes to Tech? Like, his schemes are out of this world. And the only reason why I would have been worried about this feature is because I didn't know how NF was going to come. I didn't know if he was going to come with some more sad, like, down on myself vibes, because I didn't know if that was going to mesh with Tech, because Tech is kind of like more of a braggadocious type of rapper. But NF came, so it gels well together. You know, that's the only thing I was worried about with this track.
To give you liver cirrhosis. Yeah. Boogie monster, rapper with an F and a hoodie want to step into the session and fully conquer the weapon to lessen our profession, go bully bonkers. Yeah. Left in the wreck, never checking the cookie stomp us. Take his crown. Thought it was going to make us run away in a battle with his sickest frown. Shake his ground. Like I'm the mecha Godzilla, I'm such a killer when I break it down.
These souls are the cheap. Tech's flow is crazy. It's his delivery, the rhyme scheme, and his vocal tone that is like, it's so Tech 9. But I'm not really hearing anything too crazy in there that's like, I need to like talk about, break down. You know what I'm saying?
These flows are the cheat code for the weak Joes that need those elite bros with the heat so they can eat on a D-low off a beast. Your ego got a veto. Please.
Yeah, see, that scheme is crazy. And this is a flow switch up from him. He said, these flows are the cheat code for the weak Joes that need those like that. That's a lot of rhyming. That's fire.
Girls take it from me. Thieves chose to try to decode. Yeah. Reload the beat so I can reach each soul. No cease, no finito. Release. Go!
Reload the beat so I can reach those souls. No cease, no finish. Like no finish. Like we're not done. Bro, Tech is wild.
Chose to try to decode. Yeah. Reload the beat so I can reach each soul. No cease, no finito. Release. Go! I am the chosen and everyone is beholding. My energy is going.
God damn, the switch ups, bro. The whole time from both of them.
Throw release. Go. I am the chosen and everyone is beholding. My energy is golden because the minion is being broken from enemies in the open approach. And I'm never joking. The remedy being spoken. I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. I'm in the motion.
I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. That was a dope little, like, bring it down on the note.
It's being broken from enemies in the open approach. And I'm never joking. The remedy being spoken. I'm hoping that you're soaking it up.
That's fire. That's tight. I like that. Yo, the remedy's being spoken. I hope that you're soaking it up. He's basically saying, like, he's God tier. I'm the chosen one. I'm the chosen one. Everybody beholding the golden one. Like LeBron James with his witness. Like we're witnessing greatness. So fire.
Being spoken, I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. I'm in the motion, I'm doping, I'm never choking. My devotion to floating like a notion. The Holy Ghost and I'm scoping. The evil folk, I'm provoking. The wicked notion, I'm croaking. I'm really floating and quoting that I'm closing it up. Talking behind my back.
Bro, crazy. I gotta look up what he's talking about because I can't with this guy sometimes. His delivery style is not one that I can just catch right off the ear. And I don't wanna keep pausing it and going crazy. Hold on, let me look this up real quick. Do you think the lyrics are even up online anywhere? I don't know how accurate these are going to be, because it's literally the song's maybe like 10 minutes old. I'm scoping the evil folk and revoking the wicked notion. I'm croaking like I'm dying. I really floating and quoting that I'm closing. Yo, that's fire. That's dope. Hell yeah, that's dope.
Beat you because I'm greedy and slay. If you're creepy and cray, I'ma eat you like PB&J. Hey. Kiwi and grapes. I'ma demolish them when the TB and play.
Bro, I love the fact that Tech 9 is doing what NF did, but in Tech 9 style. It's not Tech 9 style to like rap up what NF raps about. You know what I'm saying? Like Tech 9 style is exactly what he's rapping like, but he's like, I gotta switch up the flow because you're switching up the flow. I'm up to the task. I'm Tech 9, you know? So dope. And I don't think I've heard a curse word in there now that I cursed on camera right now. Not only did Hobson not cuss, nah, there's not a single cuss word in here, bro. The only problem with the way Tech 9 rhymes as fast as he does and as often as he does is that you're gonna eventually have some filler rhymes in there. You know, you're gonna say something that kind of doesn't make sense for the verse, but because you're trying to get the rhyme scheme to stay. And I feel like that's always like with any rapper. There's no way that he's rapping all of this, rhyming as much as he is, and saying everything, and like that everything he's saying matters, you know?
I started recording in my number 3 Jordans, dungaree sporting. The tongue of me is gonna be scorching. The Punisher hunter eat like a hungry orphan.
Ooh, the Punisher hungry gonna eat like a hungry orphan, bro. My tongue is scorching in my number 3 Jordans. The Jordan 3s are some of the best ones that were ever made.
My 3 Jordans, dungaree sporting. The tongue of me is gonna be scorching. The Punisher hunter eat like a hungry orphan. T9 and NF are elephants in the room without a closet for skeletons. Quit embellishing. A demon from hell is a yelling. When down in your hell, you're elephant.
Look what I Okay, we ended on, bro, the highest of notes. Low-key, high note. You know what I'm saying? He said T9, Tech9, and NF are some elephants in a room with nothing but skeletons, like skeletons in our closet, which obviously NF has a lot of buried, like he has a lot of internal issues. That's what you would call skeletons in your closet. He said, quit embellishing, the demon from hell is sent. Donnie, you're out of your element. I don't know why he called him Donnie, like Donnie Darko. I'm not sure. I don't get that reference, but just the way that he ended actually talking about the same subject matter that NF started the entire song out with, talking about those internal struggles, and Tech9 ends his verse talking about internal struggles. So clean.
Since quit embellishing, a demon from hell is sent, yell it when Donnie, you're out of your element.
Look what I done. Helping them people I love. No, I do whatever I must. Kinda one hand away trust. Kinda one hand away trust. Yeah. Kinda one hand away trust. Kinda one hand away trust.
Bruh. That it? Bro. The whole time right there, because I already knew what the hook said, I was just listening to the production, and the production is wild. I don't even know how many elements are in that production. Like, how long did that beat take to produce? You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, this track right here, crazy. I feel like this is going to be a track that you have to listen to at least 5 times. Specific, not even NF's part. You're going to get NF's part. He's still spitting quick. He's in his bag. He's in and out of the bag. You know, he's like in and out like that. And you already know his subject matter, but Tech9's, bro. Tech9 is like so layered with what he's talking about. There ain't no way I was about to sit here and try to tell you that I know every single thing that Tech9 said right there. Even I would be like, ain't no way, bro. This is gonna be like 5 times just listening to Tech9's part just to even understand and get a glimpse. But yo, this collab right here, there's not a single miss on this mixtape so far. If I go back and think about every single track that I've done, because I've done them over the last year since he started dropping tracks, there's not a single miss, and it's exactly what I wanted. When I made the video of what did I need from the Clouds mixtape, this is exactly what I was talking about. I'm hype. But yo, that brings us to the end of this video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking the video, leaving a comment down below. If you like what you see enough, please consider subscribing. All those things help the video get pushed out there to the masses and the recommended. That helps the algorithm see me, and it helps grow this community. If you're someone who wants to support the channel and you like what I do and you're in the monetary capable position to, like, you know, donate some doll hairs here and there once a month, then consider checking out the Patreon. If you're someone who would rather support on stream, we're full steam ahead on Twitch, and Twitch, it's a vibe where it's going strong over there. So if that's your vibe, if you would prefer that, then check out the Twitch. Both these links are in the description. It's the only way that I make money, so I'm grateful to anybody who signs up for either. Follow your boy on the socials, on Discord, Instagram, Twitter. All these links are in the description below. But that really brings us to the end of this video, ladies and gentlemen. This is the first video that I'm doing since Clouds has been released, so I'm hype. We're doing the rest in order after the music video, but that's all that I really gotta say. I appreciate everybody's time, and like I always say at the end, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. And I'll catch everybody in the next video. Peace.